Welcome to the fourth lecture of week 4 of the course Unit Operations of Particulate Matter. In this lecture, we will discuss mechanical conveyors. Now, if you remember the third lecture of this week, there we have started discussion on transportation of solids and we have discussed screw conveyor in mechanical conveyor category. Now, here we will continue that discussion and we will discuss few more mechanical conveyors. So, let's start with belt conveyors. So, what is belt conveyor? Belt conveyors are most commonly used powered conveyor because they are more versatile and least expensive. So, as far as belt conveyor is concerned, these are used extensively in chemical plants or in industries. One reason is they have good capacity and moreover they are less expensive. Now, when we consider belt conveyor, you understand that it has a belt which moves, because as the name says, it is belt and that belt should convey from one space to another space. So, that is nothing but the belt conveyor. So, material put over this belt and that is carried. So, you see in this case material will not move, material stay at a position and belt moves. Therefore, it is called a carrier. So, product is conveyed directly on the belt. So, both regular and irregular shaped object, large or small, light and heavy can be transported successfully. So, you see here we have discussed that regular and irregular shaped object. Now, what happens when material moves, it can put hindrance while moving when it has different shape. But in belt conveyor, as material stay on the belt and belt move, we can consider any belt, we can consider any shape of the material. So, here shape of the material, its size will not affect in transportation. So, belt conveyors can be used to transport product in a straight line or through changes in elevation or direction. So, here we can easily convey material through belt when we are transporting the material on horizontal level or vertically or an inclination. Anywhere we can send material through belt conveyor. Now, here we have some of the applications of belt conveyor: distribution of molding sands and removal of waste, fuel supply system of power station. Usually when we consider power station, coal is the raw material for that and that can be conveyed easily through belt conveyor. Underground and surface transport of coal, delivery of ores and coke in metal making industries and transport building material, fossil minerals, grains, sands and gravels. So, you see here we have some applications are discussed for belt conveyor. So, you can understand that it is used extensively in plants. Now, if you see this image shows a portable belt conveyor. Now, as far as mechanism of this belt conveyor is concerned, that we can understand through this portable conveyor, though in plant usually belts are quite long. So, here if you see, here we have one roller, another roller is at discharge end, or we can say head or rear. So, these rollers are provided at two ends from where to where belt is used for conveying the material. Now, these rollers are driven by drive. So, as this roller moves, the belt moves. Now, belt is basically kept around these rollers. You see, belt is available around these rollers and from carrying and from feed end to discharge end, the length of the belt is fixed and these length is decided by just twice the distance. Length of the belt will depend on the total distance which it has to cover and that should be almost double of that. Now, what happens when material put over here in belt, it has a sagging, or what we say that material which we put on the belt during continuous operation, it should come down. So, when material is put on this belt, after some time it has come down or sagging occurs in belt. So this problem can be sorted out by putting rollers at definite interval along the length. So from feed end to discharge end, continuous rollers are placed in between and they keep this belt straight. And similarly, we have rollers when belt is returning back. So whatever rollers are using in returning back, it has more distance in comparison to the distance we are providing when material is carrying on the belt, because during returning it does not have any material. So shape of the belt can be maintained through these rollers. So here we have two pulleys on which belt move, and we have different rollers which move with the movement of belt. If you want to study about this in detail, you can visit this link. So the drive pulley, which is located at two ends of the belt, is rotated by a drive and thus moves the belt along the path of the conveyor. At the discharge end, we call it head pulley or we call it discharge point also. The material is unloaded from the belt through an unloading funnel or hopper, or by means of plow type or pulley type unloaders. Cleaning devices are mounted at the terminal or head pulley from which the material is unloaded. Now here what happens when material is unloaded from the belt, there we have cleaning system also, because after continuous operation we have deposition of material on the belt, so that has to be cleaned out. How we clean this? Because how we clean this, at the discharge end we have a mechanism like some rotating brushes are available, so that moves over the belt to remove the material. So that can be used for sticky material as well as sand type of material. Now as far as maximum capacity which a belt can carry, that can be calculated, and for that an empirical relation has been proposed, and that is QM, that is the maximum rated capacity of the conveyor, equal to KA C beta B square V rho S, where KA and C beta are constants, B is the width of the belt, V is the linear speed of the belt, that is in meter per second, and rho S is the bulk density of the material. So using this expression we can calculate how much maximum capacity a belt can carry. So value of these coefficient KA and C beta we can see through this table. Here we have C beta value for different flowability of material like high, medium or low, and beta angle moves up to 24 degree. Beta is basically angle of inclination which moves up to 24 degree. So here we have different value of C beta. If you see this table, here we have values of coefficient KA. So this is for type of idler, so straight roughing is there. And here we have different angles of inclination, flowability of material transported for high, medium and low, we can have different value of KA. Now as far as capacity of belt is concerned, that depends on many factors such as width and speed of the belt, friction between the surface of the belt and the solids, angle of repose of the solid material. I hope you are understanding what is angle of repose. For example, if this is the belt and we put the material over here, so it makes a conical structure. For example, if this is the belt and when we put the material over here, the granular material, if we put over here, so that material prepares a conical on this and it will make an angle with this. So whatever angle of this, like if this is the cone the material makes, and the angle of this from the horizontal, this angle is called as angle of repose. Angle of inclination of the belt, the capacity depends on that, how long, how at what angle it is conveyed, it is conveying the material, at what angle it is conveying the material, stickiness of the solid materials, shape, size and specific gravity of the solid. So, all these factors we should consider when we are defining, when we are considering the capacity of the belt. Now, here if you see this image shows a conveying of material to a high point, to elevated point. So, for such purpose conveyor, for such purpose belt conveyors are suitable. Here you see in this type it is collecting the material, and you see here when we consider this, this material prepares a cone on ground, and when we consider this particular angle, this is called angle of repose. And when we have to convey the material from one point to different point as shown in this figure, like here this is one conveying belt, this is conveying belt and this is also conveying belt. So, from same source to different discharge point we can use different belts, and they are working very effectively. Here we have a few images, like you see it is transporting the material at slightly upper position. It is conveying the material at upper position, and if you see this image here in this case, it is already mountains or hilly area. So here belt conveyors can be installed effectively with a structure. Now here if you see, we in this we have that hemispherical kind of roof is there. So this is because this can be used for worse weather conditions. So sometimes we provide a roof over the belt, and sometime material moves in open environment. So here we have some images. For detail you can refer these links. Now we will discuss the apron conveyor. Now what is apron conveyor? It is similar to belt conveyor, but in belt conveyor what happens, a continuous belt is there which moves over the we can say drive pulleys, which can move over the drive pulleys. However, what happens in apron conveyor, it also has the drive pulleys, but instead of belt, metal sheets are available and they are connected to each other. So they move, the material is stayed on the metal sheet, not on the belt, because belt material of belt will not be as hard as metal sheet. So apron conveyors that we have discussed, it is similar to belt conveyor, except solids are carried in moving trough, we call it apron. And they are made with wood or metal sheet instead of continuous flexible belt. So what is apron? Apron is a load carrying element of apron conveyor. It may be made of different configurations, such as flat open, flat closed or corrugated with or without side walls. So you see, apron is basically the metal sheet, or sometimes it is prepared with wood also. So we have a rectangular sheet and these are connected side by side to prepare a chain of metal sheets. So you see, sometimes we use a plain metal or that flat metal, sometimes we put corrugated metal sheet on which friction will be there and material will stay on it. Even heavy material can stay over this. Now in apron conveyor, sometimes we use side walls and sometimes we do not use. What is side walls? It is, for example if this is the apron conveyor, here and here we have side walls. If you consider, this is the apron conveyor up to this much width, so here we have walls. So that is basically the side walls. It moves with the apron. So, apron conveyors, horizontal and inclined, are widely employed in chemical, coal processing and metal making industry and also in thermal power plant. So you see they are used in different plants, and they are used to carry the items, not only the raw material. Now when we move the material through a apron conveyor, what happens, because it is stayed on the metal sheet, we can carry out different operations over here, and these are hardening, tempering, cooling, washing, painting, assembling. All these operations can be carried out on apron conveyor, which is added advantage of apron conveyor. Unlike belt conveyors, apron conveyors can handle heavier, lumpy or abrasive material like ore and stone, etc., because it is prepared with the metal sheet, not with flexible belt. Now as far as length is concerned, the maximum length for this apron conveyor can be up to 2 km, and they provide large throughput capacity, that is more than 2000 meter cube per hour, due to high strength of hauling chains and use of intermediate drives. So here in this case we use intermediate drives also. In belt conveyor, drive pulleys are available at two ends only, but in apron conveyor we can install intermediate drive, and because of these drives as well as the metal sheet, it has more strength in comparison to belt, therefore it can have more capacity in comparison to belt conveyor. So apron conveyors are having appreciable weight of apron and chain, and consequently their higher cost and more careful maintenance is required. So that is the disadvantage of apron conveyor. Because of this metal sheet, it has more weight, and as far as cost is concerned, higher cost involved in this, in manufacturing of these kind of conveyors, and it requires careful maintenance. So that is the disadvantage with apron conveyor. Now as far as throughput capacity of conveyor, that can be calculated by an empirical relationship. Here we have the relation as 0.18 C beta B square 10 alpha R dash rho S into V. Now if you consider the apron, what is B? B is the total width of the apron. Small b is the parameter where which is the width of cone. Parameter B is basically the width made by solid material on the apron. So here you see alpha R dash is nothing but the angle of repose, and H is the height of cone which is made with the solid material. So this type of apron is without wall. And when we consider this equation, rho s over here is the bulk density of material which we have to convey, small v is the speed of conveyor meter per second, c beta is the correction coefficient, we call it angle factor, which depend on angle of inclination. So here you see c beta value we have to see from the table, otherwise other parameters we can collect from the apron itself. So beta is basically angle of inclination, which can be greater than 20 degree, and C beta value for apron without side wall and with side walls are given like this. So you see apron with the side walls has more C beta value in comparison to without side wall, because when we are using side wall, more capacity, more material can be put in the apron, so therefore capacity will increase, therefore it has more value. So these images show you the apron conveyor. If you see the first image, it is apron conveyor. Now these are basically the metal sheet which are connected with each other, and that is moved through this drive. So if we are considering this particular image, it is without wall. However, in second image you see this is basically the apron conveyor with an inclination, and here we have the side walls. So side walls will be the static section, whereas belt whereas apron conveyor moves over here. So here this side wall is not movable with the apron. So And if you are considering apron, these aprons are corrugated type of, so material which we put over here that will not displace from its position because they can stuck with this corrugates. So here these are without side wall and this is with side wall apron conveyor. For more you can refer these links. So that is all about the apron conveyor. Now we will discuss the bucket conveyor. Now what is bucket conveyor? Bucket conveyor is basically the conveyor of the shape of bucket. It takes the material and then dump to the other side. So these are specifically used when we have to drop the material from one floor to another floor or when we have to transfer the material vertically. So bucket elevators are usually used when there is not enough space for horizontal conveyor. Bucket elevator consists of buckets mounted on single or double chain. So when we see the bucket conveyor, it looks like this. Here you see different buckets are mounted like this. These are the bucket, these are mounted with the chain, these are connected with the chain, and this can be used to transfer the material vertically. Like this also. We will discuss these conveyors in detail. Now these conveyors are employed for lifting solid vertically upward or over a steep inclination when the angle of inclination is 60 to 80 degrees. So when we require very high angle of inclination or we have to transfer vertically, we should use bucket conveyors. Now we have different types of bucket conveyors and working of these bucket conveyors are different. So let's discuss what are the types of bucket. First is centrifugal discharge elevator, second is continuous discharge elevator, and third is positive discharge elevator. We will discuss details of one of each. So here we have centrifugal discharge elevator. So if you see here we have different buckets which are mounted on endless chain. If you see this side here we have chain and over which these buckets are attached. So what happens, it takes the material from this, it is basically loading point, it takes material on each bucket and these are transferred vertically, and at this point the material when it is returning back, it drops them, it discharges the material to the other side. So in this way the centrifugal discharge elevator works. So when it discharges the material, it has centrifugal action, that's why it is called centrifugal discharge elevators. Application of these elevators are to carry grain, coal, sand, clay, sugar and dry chemical, but specifically when we have to transfer the material vertically. For details you can refer this link. Here we have continuous discharge elevators. Now what happens in continuous discharge elevator, that buckets are mounted without any gap on a chain or belt. So you see when we are considering centrifugal discharge elevator, their bucket are mounted while keeping some distance between two buckets, but here buckets are continuously attached one by one. So when we it carries the material and it discharges the material to other end, therefore it is called continuous because these are attached very close to each other, so material can be transferred continuously. These elevators operate at a speed range of 30 to 50 meter per minute, which is much lower than that of centrifugal discharge type. Application in lime, cement and dry chemical plants, there we can use such type of elevators. For details you can go through this link. Further we have a bucket conveyor and that is positive discharge elevator. Now what happens in these elevator, if you consider these bucket, these are rectangular buckets. And here we have this chain kind of structure. Now these buckets are attached with this chain. Now what happens when it has to discharge, the assembly is like that, it will be this section will move to this side and it can be completely inverted to the side where we have to discharge, and therefore it is called as positive discharge elevator because it is completely inward to the discharge side. So this type of elevator is used in handling light, fluffy, dusty and sticky material. The feeding is done by scooping or digging by the buckets. So for more you can refer this link. So you see here in this particular lecture we have discussed belt conveyor, apron conveyor and bucket conveyor. All these are used as a carriers. So here we are stopping discussion on mechanical conveyor, and that's all for now. Thank you.